Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I'm going to continue getting up all of the resources that we need to make all of this stuff. Now I've almost got everything for that satellite and the rocket silo. We've got a few more bits to gather. I'm just after fuel for the satellite and then we're done. Is it fuel? No, I also need a couple of the low-density structures there, but I'm just changing that round slightly so that the robots bring it in. I have since found out that when you've built the rocket silo, you've then got to build the rocket, and the rocket requires low-density structures, it requires rocket fuel, and it requires the rocket control modules. Now, I apologise, because I probably said this in the last episode as well. So I'm going to need to alter a few things around so that I can continue producing all of those, which means I'm going to need a lot more of the purple production units. Is production units? I think it's... And it's not production units. Production modules. Production... You know, I really can't remember that. Processing units. Processing units. That's the ones they are. The purple processing units. And in order to make those, I need two of the red advanced circuits. And I need 20 of the green electronic circuits. So I'm going to need loads of those because the rocket control modules, they require the purple processing units, as do the rocket silo and the satellite themselves. So we need lots of processing units, which means we need gazillions of green electronic circuits. We're also going to need steel. We need 1,000 steel, and I need to pilfer a little bit out of the chest there so that I can make a few more items, so that I can make more steel. It's kind of a vicious circle. I hope you understand. I've also got to keep a bit of an eye on the electricity because I'm going to be putting down more electronic furnaces. I like electronic furnaces as opposed to steel and regular furnaces because of the lack of fuel that is needed. It does mean, though, that you've got to stay on top of your vast fields of solar panel arrays. Now, at the moment, I make my solar fields with like individual modules, and I am considering changing that round so that I've got a big field of accumulators and a big field of solar panels. I think that could look kind of cool, although I'm not 100% certain yet. There's something that we'll play around with when we move on to the new map after we've launched our rocket from this one, because I have decided I am definitely going to do it. Once we have launched the rocket off of this planet, we are going to crash land onto another planet where the bugs aren't quite so unfriendly, and will leave us alone if we leave them alone. Probably won't leave them alone. We'll probably do some nasty things to them because, you know, we're like that. But they won't fight us unless we pick a fight with them first, which is sort of a step up from what we got at the moment. Anyway, we want to keep a close eye on the electricity here, and I am just monitoring how far down it drops, and it went down to 472 megajoules before it started to rise again. As we got to put down more factory units yet and increase the productivity of some of the factory units that we've got, we are definitely going to need more power coming in fairly soon. So I will just get ready to do that at some point. First of all, however, I want to set up so that I can start making the rocket control modules. And to do those, you need the speed modules. Rocket control unit, I should say. That one right there. You need a processing unit and you need a speed module. It's just a regular speed module, fortunately, because otherwise that is just going to need a ridiculous amount of the processing units. And we're already shy on the green electronic circuits. We need to make those anyway. So we're just going to have to play this carefully. We'll get those making. And these, I found, can be a bit slow to make, actually. It's not so much these speed modules that slow things down. The rocket control module themselves, they take 30 seconds for each one to build. So if I get a faster factory, get a yellow factory onto it, that should speed the process up a little bit. The rocket silo, it can have productivity modules put onto it so that it decreases the amount of resources that you need. However, it does need 10 each of low density structures, rocket fuel, and these rocket control units. And that makes 1% of the rocket. So we're going to need 100 times 10, which is 1,000. We need 1,000 of those. That's the base number, and they take 30 seconds each to make, which by my reckoning is 30,000 seconds. I don't actually know. I'm going to, while I talk, I'm just going to actually work that out. The 30,000 seconds is, I think I got, yes, I have worked that out correctly. So we want 30,000 seconds, 1, 2, 3, and we want to divide that by 60. That would give us 500 minutes, which is, actually that's a little under 10 hours. There's 8 hours and 20 minutes. 8 hours and 20 minutes if we just produce them ourselves. So we're gonna, we need some assistance with that. The processing units into the, not the processing units, the productivity modules into the rocket silo, that is gonna help that a huge amount. Drastically reduce the number that we need, and then just boosting the speed of everything as well. I'm siphoning off a bit of excess steel down the bottom, and I'm also increasing the speed and efficiency that these rocket fuel get produced. I'm removing the production limit on them as well, because I did originally have it set to 50, but I'm going to remove that production limit so that we can fill that chest right up. So we've got a faster factory, I've got more modules on it, that's going to give us a decent amount of rocket fuel. And I sort of want to make sure that everything is all running like that. And yeah, look, fortunately these are just medium biters. These are just mediums. We haven't even got to the stage of evolution where we got the large ones coming out yet, so we will just have to be a little bit careful with that. I am going to increase the laser turret's damage and speed so that we are better able to fend off incoming attacks, because at the moment our laser turrets really are being pushed to their absolute limit. So putting a few speed modules into here, I'll put some speed and possibly even productivity modules into those as well. I've got all of the low density. I've got everything now that I need to make the satellite. I still need engines, processing units and steel to make the rocket silo, but we're getting pretty close to completing that one as well. Once we do have that completed, we'll then be able to actually start producing, working on the rocket itself. So we're getting really close. We are getting really, really close to actually being able to launch our rocket and get off of this rock, which will be fantastic. So I'm going to put down a couple more of these just so that we can stay on top of... I won't come down there any further because that's actually out of range. Yeah, we want to stay on top of the electricity production. This... kind of embarrassing when everything runs out. We don't want to do that. And I need to put in that extra production line for the processing units. Before I do that, let's just double check everything up here. I'm going to need more of these. So if I put in some speed and some productivity modules like that, that'll slightly increase the amount that we're getting of the electronic circuits. But I've got to be honest, I'm thinking we're probably going to need another production line of them all together. We'll do that in a bit. We want to have a look down and set up a second factory for these processing units. We're going to need to make sure that we got the right amount of stuff coming in for it. And I mean, overall, all we need is the sulfuric acid there and the red ones, though we only need two red ones at a time, so we don't need very many of those. So really, I think the biggest holdup for making more of these processing units is going to be electronic circuits. At 20 of them for each processing unit, it is kind of expensive on that. It's just, yeah, I think what we're going to need to do is just set up a whole new unit for it. Now, I'm just trying to get the sweet spot for where to put all of this, and yeah, that's still not the right place. So third time's a charm. Let's move it in a little bit. Go on, Frith. You can do it. Yeah, move that in, and there's the sweet spot for that one. That will join to both of them, but we are actually going to need to put in a conveyor belt for that one, I think. Right, let's do that. There we go. Third time's a charm, like I said. The electronic circuits. I was actually quite surprised to find that we are Struggling to get copper more than anything else, we got plenty of iron now, and I thought that we had loads of copper and that there was no chance of us running out. But we're actually producing, we're actually stripping out almost all of the copper that is available to us. There is a little bit more that we could get just here, just above us, but we are pretty much covering all the rest of the copper. There's another little bit just to the eastern side of these solar panels that we've got down here, but that's only maybe a couple of mining drills worth. So hopefully, I am hoping, and this is a big fingers crossed, we've got enough copper here within our safe zone to actually get this rocket launched, because if we haven't, we're going to get a little bit, it's going to be a little bit embarrassing. We're going to have to try and fight our way through a load more bugs and see if we can't find a bit more copper. And I don't think there's any that close to us, to be honest. There might be a patch down the south, but I'm not really sure. It was iron that I remember seeing. I don't remember seeing a lot of copper. Yeah, we will have to have a look at that. Yeah, for some reason here, my robot picked up the piece of concrete rather than the inserter that I told him to pick up. Not quite sure. I'm just tidying a few things up a bit, removing any underpasses that we don't need to use anymore, so that it just make it a little bit more efficient. We'll be able to tidy all of that up again a little bit later on. The ore is almost completely used up, and once that's gone, we'll just be able to have one or two belts going through there, splitting off to wherever we've got the furnaces. Now, that is all processing units needed for the satellite and for the rocket silo. I've not got loads of them in my bag anymore, because I just took out the ones that I was requesting, but the robots will slowly fill those up. So all we need now for the rocket silo is the steel and the engine units. Surprisingly, the engine units are actually slowing us down a little bit. Not going to be a huge issue, I don't think. They will sort of come along eventually. I suspect it's the steel that's going to slow us down the most. But once we've got the 1,000 steel there available, we're not going to need to worry about it too much anymore, because the only thing that we then use steel for is the low density structures, and we don't use masses of steel for that. I'm just speeding things up a little bit down there. Just trying to streamline everything really now. Get blue factories in and get fast inserters, and then we've got a line of iron plates there. If I put in another extraction point so that it goes into the logistics network, that'll be available to feed in elsewhere. And I'd like to add another furnace or two just there where I'm making that steel. I will do regular steel furnaces, and they can still be fed by this coal, because I don't think there's any chance of running out of that coal once I've made those. But I'm just, as the attacks happen and it looks like we're taking a lot of damage, I like to just nip up and double check that everything is all right. I mean, we got roboports in range here, so they are repairing, but that seems to be the heaviest attack point there. So I've just thrown all of my extra laser turrets down, and now here on this production line here, I'm just putting a chest, and we're requesting a load of steel. I don't want to put it right there. I actually need to just move these belts around a little bit so that I can get the steel going in onto the right sides. And I also want to make sure that the steel coming out of the furnaces is being used as a priority over the steel that is being pushed out of the delivery chest. So if I move these around a bit as well, I'll get rid of the underpass once I've put these in, put down the inserters and so on into these, and a couple of extra belts, there we go. And now I just want to remove the underpass further back so that that is taking priority. The copper ore is coming in, but it's actually starting to slow down a little bit. So if we change this around, the ore coming in is going to be used as priority over the plates coming in out of that chest there. Actually, I think bullet shooting speed. I'm only doing that because I want to use less blue science packs just for a second so that I can let the belts fill up again. So yeah, we'll move this around. I'll swap the direction of the belts around and pop them in like that so they're moving in, and then put that one in that side so that the request to chest is still working, but now the priority is being given to anything that's coming out of the furnaces. How are we doing down here? We've got... those are all done. Processing units there. And... yeah, make another couple of... I'm going to make some more yellow factories. Those are... if I just tidy this up a bit as well. Change some... the number of regular inserters that we've got lying around, being used as part of the network that we actually want to change to fast inserters is quite surprising, and it does make a little bit of a difference. We've got plenty of coal there, we're not going to need to worry about that. But I think this is the ideal spot to set up a production run of green electronic circuits. So I'm going to need to feed copper plates out here so that we can take the excess copper plates that are coming off of this production line. And we'll use those to turn into copper wire. I don't need them to go quite that high. And I actually got those factories in the wrong place. I need to move them out by one so that they can feed in. There we go. Right, those are going to make copper wire. So I'll put down all of the inserters. And I'm going to use fast belts so that they should feed all the factories effectively. I put another line of factories up. I've got to put a requester chest down here and request iron, so that feeds in. I don't want to belt the iron in from anywhere else. That will just come off anywhere that we've got excess. Increased cargo size on the logistics robots is going to be very valuable. And here I'm just actually doing the copy and paste thing where you can shift... right click on a factory and then shift left click on the others and it will just copy whatever you've input into it. It's a really handy trick, that one. Make a few more logistics robots, because now that we're using so many requester chests for iron plates and things like that, it would be useful to have a few more robots, because we're starting to get to the point where we're using them. They're all sort of being used in places in the network. Right, I've got... those four factories are producing there. If I just put a belt down and run that into a chest, it's actually going to produce faster than the... it's going to produce faster than this fast inserter can remove things. So I'm just going to put one across, but the actual reason that it is producing faster is because we've got an excess of copper. We're not always going to have an excess of copper, because now that the electronic circuits are coming across as well as the copper, they're producing more solar panels. So they're being taken up by the solar panels. We've got a... it would be nice if we had a surplus of electronic circuits, but we haven't. We've got a... what's the word when... I think it's a dearth, isn't it? It's a dearth of electronic circuits. But yes, we've got a serious shortage of those anyway. So I'm just reducing the number of these that I've got being requested into the network so that it doesn't keep taking them all. And then we can have that those copper plates, which are also being used for the solar panels, they'll start coming up being turned into wire, which in turn will then be turned into electronic circuits. So we've got four more factories making electronic circuits. Excuse me, I am so sorry. It's kind of, we just need to keep streamlining. I might need to increase the amount of electronic circuits that we are producing. That seems to be, I mean, overall on the rest of the network, it seems to be that the biggest shortage is actually those electronic circuits. We just need steel and engine units here. We only need 57 more electronic engines to finish doing that. Although I think I'm still sharing electronic engines with the robot frames. Not sure, am I or not? Oh no, I've got those limited, so I'm not actually taking those electronic frames anymore. I'm just using them for any that are being produced now are going straight over towards the the rocket silo. I keep forgetting what everything's called. Part of the reason that those are slowed down is because they also use these electronic circuits. It's this same line that's running right down here. So there is a major shortage of electronic circuits. So I'm thinking that we may have to try and find a way to get more copper coming across here so that we can make more electronic circuits. But looking at it, I don't think we've got anywhere that we can sort of safely extract it without disrupting any other supply lines anywhere. So this is something that we're going to have to give a little bit of careful thought to, because we're going to need masses of it yet. We may end up having to... There is that little bit of copper down by in the southeast. There's a tiny little bit there, right up against the coast, that could sort of make a little bit of a difference, and we do have enough space for a couple more mining drills just here that we could put some in. These are... Yeah, we're just the one factory is using everything that's being produced there at the moment. Like I said, so I am sorry, I've kind of actually talked right over the end of this. If you enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Next time, we will continue our research into how we can optimize our green electronic circuit production, because this is the bit that is going to keep us on this planet the longest, I think. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.